Good morning. My name is Adam. I'm happy today to present my final report of my thesis. The title is Linked Spatial Data via Linked Open Data Cloud.
Hello, Fania. Can you hear us? Okay.
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me? Yes.
Yeah.
Great.
Okay.
The presentation just started.
Okay. To mention about the core of this research is about the linking of data cloud. It is a community project by W3C. The goal of this project is to build a data common by making the various open data sources on the web available as RDF, and also to create an RDF link between data sources from different data. And we can say the LD cloud is sort of constellations of available linked data sets on the web. This project is encourage new creations of linked data by providing like nicely representations and also data sources that relate to the data catalog. Those functionality are expected to support user to, let's say, discover, explore, and also integrate data sets. It's supposed to do that, but we don't know yet the content behind this representation. That's why we aim to analyze the representations, data structures, as well as the quality. That brings us to the research objective. The first is to evaluate the current states of spatial datasets. The second is to determine the potential use of LD cloud diagram. And then third is to design a workflow for integration purposes. So this is to address to objective one. Workflow one was developed. It consists of three parts that we zoom in. The first part is identification, how we can discover datasets on the web. And here we use the data catalog of datahub.io. And then the second part, since we get the candidate datasets, the whole resources will assess using the data processing module. And then the last part is, since we got the analysis, we can generate some useful information to address our research questions. And about data catalog here, as we know that the natures of the linked data is distributed or not centralized, so the data catalog provides a good starting point to discover data sets on them as it provides metadata. And here, the data hub OYO from CTAN provides a DC80 or data catalog vocabulary, specifically DC80 keyword. On the other hand, data hub OYO also implements the CTAN domain model. It is a metadata model, how the data catalog describes the metadata information here. One of them is the CTAN entity text. This element has been mapped to the text, so it's equally definition, so we can use this element to discover our data set. And not only consider the text, we also consider the data that have to have format of RDF serializations. And second, we have a full access to the data sets either through Sparkle endpoint or the RDF dump. So after analyzing hundreds of data sets on the web, we choose 26 data sets, so it's equal like 500 million triples on the web we will assess. And this is the last part of my first workflow. We will more elaborate in this part. So we use two parameters here. The first is the existence of geospatial anthology. The second parameter is the existence of external URI in the object of a triple. So we're going to assess the content of linked spatial data here. So every resources that fulfill two parameters here is categorized as linked spatial data in the study. So as a result, here in table 2.5, we list every geospatial vocabulary within datasets, as well as the external URI that link in the dataset. And then the interesting part is we found 32 ontologies were used in 26 datasets, meaning that this is such a redundant ontology development, because I found several vocabulary define the same concept and definitions. So instead of promoting to reuse the existing vocabulary, the data provider is tend to build their ontology. And then more findings of objective one, I found only three dataset that link using the geospatial vocabulary that also link to the external URI. Move to the second objective, it's more to the visualization part. We found from the existing visualization system, there is a gap or limitations. The existing visualization system, which not able to capture the bigger insights or overview of F-level data sets. So here we try to approach this problem using two elements. The first is to conduct the expert opinion. The second is to analyze the link set and data set concept. So here, the result of the expert opinion from the link data consumption guidelines. So some of functionalities are expected to support the discovery, like let's say multi-level exploration and also collapsible graph. The idea here is to identify in which element are the gaps in the existing visualization. And however, from these five components, the opening and overview is most highlighted by the expert, since it's corresponding to the current capabilities of LD Cloud Diagram to capture the overview visualizations. And then, since we got this gap, we try to bridge this gap by relating to other concepts. The concept is the different granularities of dataset and link sets. This concept is providing, say, a conceptualization and organization of metadata from different level of data. Here, one dataset could have several subsets, and one subset could have several distribution. So the link, the LREL, the link itself exists in the distribution level. So can easily aggregate it into the subset level and also to the dataset level. So it can be used for the overview visualization as the basis for visualization. And then just to resume the findings, of course the overview is important for dataset discovery, and then the link set from different categories as the best information for top-level relationship visualizations. Move to the to address objective three, or hopefully was DevMob. The first part is preparation, how you can convert multiple data format to the triples. And second part is integration. We will concentrate into the second part about integrations. In this thesis, we provide two case studies. The first is geometry-based integration between the Natura 2000, which contain threatened species. And here we choose the dragonflies distributions. And another hand, cadastre contain a water area, water bit. And the second case study is toponym-based. Both of cadastre and geonames is contained properties of toponym. So regarding this condition, at least four important steps are needed. The first is to model the geometry data using the OGC GeoSparkle vocabulary, geometry extensions element, specifically the geo as the WKT. For the toponym base, the most important part is to define different ontologies, to define the concept from different ontologies, because we found that toponyms are duplicate. It appeared like several times in Netherlands. We found like the Witteveen, when I'm writing a thesis, appear five times in different classes and also different place. So it's important part, the data access. For integrating data, we use the SILK integration framework. SILK allow to call and retrieve from two different data sources, either from remote endpoint and also local deployment, by posing a correct Sparkle query. The third step is spatial transformation and spatial blocking. It's needed to reduce the complexity of the geometry computations. And the last part is link conditions. Link condition is based on our interest to materialize the line, the link. For the geometry, of course, we will use the topological vocabulary. For the toponym base, since the resource write in the text or string, we will use similarity. We use similarity measures, the dice similarity and also the 100 equality. And then this is all to resume the finding. Yeah, geometry and toponym is important, and also ontology as the basis for data retrieval, consumption, and integrations. And then to conclude these presentations, first is most of the special data sets only refer to their own resources, so linked data that not so linked data at the moment. Second, overview is important for data discovery by using different granularities. The third part is special component is as important hook to linking different data sets. Last part about recommendation, I recommend to use the GeoDC80 to retrieve more data sets from different across data platform. And then the second part is to compare complex ontologies, appropriate method can be used like ontology matching in the ontology field of area. And then the third is to compute the big data sets. Parallel computation is needed because we talked about million triples on the web. And in the last part, to get more data, in here I refer to the toponym, web scraping, and also natural language processing method would be interesting to use. Thank you.